equation of continuity. So the equation of continuity for the incompressible non-viscous fluid having a steady flow through a pipe. So again I will say that this is the equation of continuity for the incompressible non-viscous fluid having a steady flow. Steady flow means the different layers of the liquid flow in same speed, that is a constant velocity, flows through the pipe. Here the pipe shows that the area of the pipe here at the point A is A1, but the area of the pipe at the point B is A2. So A1 is greater than A2. Area of the A1 is greater than A2. So the liquid which is flows in this point A is velocity is V1. The liquid which flows through the tube at the which is crossing the point B is V2. So the same liquid which is flows from the point A to B, here the velocity is V1, here the velocity is V2. Area of cross section is A1, here the area of cross section is A2. So let us consider a certain time, at a fixed time delta T. So what is the length traveled by this liquid in this liquid area? So this liquid will travel this distance at a V1 delta T, because L, so L1 which is equal to V1 delta T, that is a length is equal to distance which is equal to velocity into time. Similarly, the distance traveled at a given time delta T is V2 delta T. So velocity into time at the same constant time, both will covers a different distance because the velocity is not same. So we know that the density of the liquid is equal to mass by volume. So mass which is equal to density into volume. So mass is equal to density is rho and volume is V. So volume is a multiplication of area into length. So this length is V1 delta T at point A and V2 delta T at point B. Okay. So at point A, rho V, that is a mass which is equal to density into volume, that is a density into area into length. So at point A, the mass which is crossing this point is M1 is equal to the liquid, the mass of the liquid which is crossing the point A is given by M1 is equal to rho A, that is A is the area of cross section at the point A is A1. So A1, the length is V1 delta T. So the distance covered is V1 delta T. Similarly, at point B, the amount of mass, the mass of the liquid crossing this particular point B, M2 is equal to rho A2 V2 delta T. Okay. So why the same rho will be put that? Because the same liquid only goes, because this is an incompressible liquid. So by the conservation of mass, that is amount of liquid flows in this point A must be come out here. So no liquid will be lost or gained. So that is the conservation of mass. M1 must be equal to M2. So if you equate these two things, rho rho get cancelled, delta T get cancelled, we get A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. So I will equate these two things, A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, that is the area of cross section A1 and the velocity V1 at a point A, product of area of cross section and velocity is equal to at point B, area of cross section and velocity of the liquid. Simply A into V, the product of area into velocity is constant. This is the equation of continuity of an incompressible non-viscous fluid having a steady flow through the pipe. So according to equation of continuity, it states that during the streamlined flow of a non-viscous and incompressible fluid through a pipe of varying cross section. Varying cross section means here the cross section is higher, here the cross section is lesser. So varying cross section, the product of area of cross section, the product of area of cross section and the normal fluid velocity, under the normal fluid velocity remains constant throughout the flow. So that is a statement of equation of continuity. So this is a important for Bernoulli's theorem. So we should know that what is the equation of continuity for streamlined flow. Equation of continuity for streamlined flow. What is streamlined flow? The any flow which has a constant velocity, different layers of the liquid has the same velocity, is called streamlined flow.